So the Indian Premier League is back, and I've got a guy here who knows a thing or two about cricket. Hi, Aakash.
Hi.
So what are you looking forward to most in the coming IPL?
Well, lots of things to look forward to in the coming IPL. Of course, two teams are coming back. So CSK and Rajasthan Royals, they are making a comeback. So it'll be interesting to see how they actually pan out in the end, because there are lots of expectations with regards to these two franchises. You talk about a lot of player movement as well. This was a big auction where a lot of players changed base, and therefore how they'll perform in a new franchise, a new setup. They're very new look, quite a few new look, new looking teams. And so whenever you find that kind of combination with two new teams and a lot of new look teams, that's enough for you to excite for a season ahead.
Also, a lot of new captains. Hmm. So, what is the one who is the one captain that you're looking for?
Well, lots of captains are there. So, I'm eager to see how Ravi Chandran Ashwin actually goes about doing his business. A completely unknown commodity. Kings XI Punjab have invested in him, and therefore, it'll be interesting to see how he goes about.
So, being a Delhi wala yourself, what do you think Delhi's chances are this year?
Quite good, and I'm not saying this because I'm standing in Delhi and Dil Delhi hai, but because of the way they've picked their side. When you look at their squad, just go through the team sheet at the auction table, you'll find that they've covered almost all bases. They've got a wonderful captain in place, and there is no reason for them to not finish in the top four, if not actually the top two, because this could be their season of reckoning, their season of change. They've been quite a few times they've been the bridesmaid, never the bride, but maybe this time around.
There are a lot of former players coming back as coach this year. What do you think about Nehra ji?
Nehra ji is a dear friend, and I know that he'll make a great coach, because that's something that's very close to his heart. Even when he was playing, he had already assumed that responsibility without even being asked. So he was mentoring the younger ones. He was there for them all the time, putting an arm around a younger kid, telling him what to do, what not to do on off the field. So he's the kind of guy that you would want in your side, come what may. And I think Royal Challengers Bangalore, Virat Kohli, well done. You've gone for the right guy.
Talking about young players, who are the young players that you're looking forward to this season?
Quite a few, actually. A couple of them are in the Kolkata Knight Riders, and they will get opportunities. Kamlesh Nagarkoti, my favourite pick. I think he is very good. He's got the promise, he's got the potential. The other guy is Shubman Gill, once again with the same franchise. So these are the two guys I'm eagerly looking at.
But these are guys we haven't really seen in the T20 format, right? These are under-19 stars.
Correct.
So is that, do you think that would also pose a challenge for them?
It is a huge challenge. It's a huge step up for anyone who's played first class cricket or just under 19 cricket, because IPL is a different beast, a beast that is very difficult to conquer and neutralize. They will find out that it's a huge step up, but that is where we'll get to know whether they have it in them to take it to the next level or not. But don't be too critical, don't be too disappointed if they fail a few times. They deserve a longer rope. Once they get an opportunity, just keep them there for a few games and see what they can do. I have full faith in their abilities. I think they'll make the graduation to the next level in this IPL itself.
What about Mayank Agarwal? He's had a great domestic season. What do you think about him?
Fantastic domestic season, but he is with the Kings XI Punjab, and may or may not get enough opportunities. You know, team selection is not just about justice, it's about balance. So while you want Mayank Agarwal to play because of the kind of form that he's in, but if you've got an Aaron Finch, you've got a Chris Gayle, you've got a KL Rahul, you've also got a Karun Nair, how do you fit in Mayank Agarwal in that jigsaw puzzle? So he might miss out, but then if he does, so be it, can't be helped.